Welcome to Art Attack number 6. I'm indebted to Bill for his Art Attack number 5. It's very interesting. Today, we're moving away from a particular piece of art, necessarily, to an artist. And I want to share with you these. You will recognize them instantly as Vincent van Gogh's painting of the church at Auvers and also of his own bedroom at Arles. This painting at of his bedroom hung in the art department in school when I was at secondary school. And I used to look at it, because I've got not an artistic bone in my body. I used to look at it thinking, oh, what's so special about that? It's just rubbish. You know, anybody could have done that. A child could have done that. I mean, I was always rubbish, so I couldn't have done it. But I couldn't understand why that was a masterpiece. And over the years, I've learned to see more of Van Gogh's work and to very much appreciate him more. So we're moving on now. Let me just move myself up there. There's a painting of the gentleman himself. Wonderful man. Interesting, troubled character. When Sue and I went to Amsterdam a couple of years ago, just for a long weekend, we booked tickets for the Van Gogh Museum, and it was wonderful. It was wonderful. I could have spent hours and hours and hours and hours there. The reality was that we were only there for a long weekend, so we didn't actually get as long in the museum as I would have liked. And the paintings were just incredible. The church at Auvers, of course, hangs in Paris. It's not actually in Amsterdam, so we didn't see that, but there was lots of others. If you ever go to Amsterdam, you must go to the museum. One of the things, the thing I like most about Vincent van Gogh is the heavy brush strokes. I think that's ultimate, it's the detail. It's not so much the actual finished product from a distance. It's the intimate detail. I could spend, and it's not like me really, I could spend hours just staring at his brushstroke. There's just something I find mesmerizing about them. The two really colorful ones here are taken from various pieces he's done. And it's just layer of thick and paint on top of more paint and more paint. And yet it works when you stand back. This guy has seen this image. And yet you've got the starry night, the famous starry sky, starry night image in the blue. And there's parts of the canvas is actually missed, which again, just absolutely blows my head. I just so love about that. So here we are. We've got the church at Auvers-sur-Vars, and it's a fascinating picture. Like I said, it hangs in Paris. People seem to think that he chose this partly because he lived there, obviously, and bless him, he committed suicide just a month after this painting was finished. He liked this because of the divergent paths, which says a lot about his own mental state, I should think. But it's also interesting the fact that there's lots of sunlight, lots of brightness. That's what I love about Van Gogh, the way that he can make the sky so vibrant. So a lot of colour, a lot of sunshine there. And yet this church itself is not reflecting any light. And those who know about these things suggest it's because his own desire to be some form of evangelical preacher had been vetoed. And it was a response to the fact that actually the preaching of the day was dull, that it offered nothing to people. But I do think it's a beautiful painting. It is one of my very favourite Van Gogh paintings. And actually, I prefer the painting to the original, the actual church itself. So there we are, Vincent van Gogh, the church at Auvers. And I leave that with you in the recognition that there is a creative spark of genius in each of us. We might not be able to do art such as this, but we are all God's children, all created in his image, all very special and unique in his sight, and we all have a wonderful gift to give and to share. So bless you all, and thank you for watching.